Welcome back to Ring of Fire. I'm Mike Papantonio. The FDA has become so dysfunctional that they're almost completely useless at this stage. When they were presented with evidence of the drug Pradaxa's potential to kill people, they signed off on it anyway. Joining me to talk about this is attorney Ned McWilliams. It seems like almost every week, Ned, we hear another story about the FDA dropping the ball, not doing their job, as an agency that's become wholly dysfunctional. This new story about Pradaxa is very, very troubling. Lay it out for us.
Yeah, it is, Pap. Basically, we have this drug that we don't need. And as of the last reports, the last figures, there's been over anywhere between 15,000 and 150,000 people who have bled to death on this drug, Pradaxa. And the issue is, and again, as you pointed out, it's the FDA. The FDA has dropped the ball. And the problem is that the FDA was in such a hurry to approve this drug that they quit doing their job. They forgot their job. And they broke all their own rules. They let this drug get approved with one study when traditionally you have to have two studies. They normally make you do double-blind placebo-controlled studies. Here, they did something called open label, which means the investigator and the patients knew what drug they were on. So of course, there's bias there. And they did fast-track approval and priority review drugs for a process that's traditionally reserved for new AIDS drugs or new cancer drugs. This is not an AIDS drug or cancer drug. This is for atrial fibrillation,
It's an unnecessary drug. I mean, let's begin there. You have another drug, warfarin, that does exactly the same thing, only you don't bleed to death and die when you take warfarin if it's done right.
That's here, exactly right.
Here you bleed to death and die, and while you're dying on the table, the company has nothing to stop the bleeding with. They have no antidote at all. And the FDA knew that. The FDA said, well, you don't need an antidote. Just let people bleed to death. But what's interesting to me is now you have scientists and doctors and hospitals looking at the way the FDA approved this drug, and they're saying, basically, what a disaster.
That's right. There's what I call a growing chorus of doctors and experts that say we need to do an independent audit, an independent review of this clinical trial that served as the basis for approval of this drug, because nobody's believing it now. Because like I said, they had this one clinical trial that makes the drug look good, but now in the real life, in the real world, thousands and thousands of people are bleeding to death, and doctors are saying this enough is enough. We need to get to the bottom of this.
The makers of Pradaxa come out and say, well, gee whiz, people bleed to death. People bleed from warfarin. The difference is they don't bleed to death on warfarin.
That's
five
right.
times the number of people that take warfarin and take Pradaxa, five times the number of people taking Pradaxa are going to bleed to death because there's no way to stop it. Now, who's getting this? I mean, your mothers, your fathers, your grandparents. This is a drug that is sold in a large part to elderly. Why is that?
That's right. It's a drug for atrial fibrillation, which is a very common ailment. 2 to 3 million Americans have atrial fibrillation. And you're right, the overwhelming majority of those patients are over 75. Overwhelming majority of the Pradaxa patients are over 80. And those are the patients at the highest risk of bleeding to death. And those are exactly the patients who shouldn't be on this drug.
Well, you had Pradaxa and the manufacturers of Pradaxa come in and say, gee whiz, this is a great, and by the way, the company, let's put the cards on the table. It's Boehringer Ingelheim, which is a German company. We know just across the board that what they've done is they've unloaded this drug here in America because they make more money selling the drug in America than they do in other countries. Because
That's right.
In America, they can game the system and make almost twice as much selling it in America as they can in Canada or Japan or even Germany for that matter. So they're unloading this poisonous drug here in America. And people that are taking it are at risk of dying in what way? Tell me what you've seen with this drug.
Well, it's these situations, and you see these case reports for some of the most startling case reports were people who took one single pill bleed to death. There's a very famous report in the literature of an 81-year-old gentleman who took one pill and bled to death. There's also these stories you hear you keep talking about, Pap, how there's no reversal agent, where people will have a very simple trauma, like they'll stub their toe or have a nosebleed, and people are literally bleeding to death from nosebleeds and from stubbed toes. And I know that sounds ridiculous, but it's true.
Tell me who the ISMP is. Tell the viewers what the ISMP is, and tell them what the ISMP found when they did their job after the FDA failed to do their job.
The ISMP is the Institute for Safe Medicine Practice, and they put out a publication every quarter called Quarter Watch, where they look at adverse event reports, which is where doctors and patients tell the FDA or tell a drug company, look, there's this bad stuff happening whenever someone takes your drug. And what they did was they looked at not just the numbers, but they looked at the nature of the events of patients who are on warfarin, who are on Pradaxa, or even some of these other newer drugs like Xarelto or Eliquis. And what they found was that the patients on Pradaxa, if you suffered a bleed, and they looked at people on warfarin and the people who suffered bleeds on Pradaxa, and they found that the Pradaxa patients were 5 times more likely to die as a result of that bleed. So it's not a matter, some people like to say, well, it's the new drug and that's why it's being reporting new. It's not the number of events that's so high, it's the nature. It's like you said, people bleed on warfarin, people bleed on Pradaxa, but you're much more likely to die as a result of a bleed on Pradaxa, and that's the problem.
Well, first of all, the Boehringer Ingelheim has claimed that this drug is their cash cow. So as their cash cow, we can bet on one thing, and that is the FDA will continue not doing their job because of the influence of industry. The revolving door of industry is going to have a huge impact here, isn't it?
That's absolutely correct. If you look at the individuals involved in this particular case, I can tell you that they all are former industry workers. The point person at the FDA who's responsible for overseeing this particular drug, Pradaxa, she used to work at Merck, the company that's famous for the major Vioxx disaster.
Yeah, Ned, the truth is, until some people are arrested and prosecuted for this type of crime, and it is a crime, to allow this to happen, we're not going to see any difference in the United States, I'm afraid. Ned McWilliams, thank you for joining me.